Everybody and welcome to another video. In this video, it's going to be my Air Tycoon 4 series. Now, last time, we were phasing in the rest of our DC-10s to phase out the DC-8s completely. And then, yeah, I just had those five at the end of the episode, which, yeah, I have now completely phased out, but to show you. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, there's not a single DC-8 left in my airline. So, yeah, I just put the DC-10s in, as I said, the DC-10-10s. And, yeah. We had that 747. What was that 747 before? I can't remember. Oh yeah, that was going to Atlanta, I think, wasn't it? Yeah, because there were, because that's got like 400 tour, and yeah, it's with the DC-10. Yeah, let's just have a look. Yeah, it was that. So yeah, let me just put that in, and like so. If I can actually take that off and put it in, do I have to change any slots? No. It's been nice to meet today, so yeah! Now that we've phased in the rest of our DC-10s and 747s and whatnot, we can finally start, making some more routes. So, the first one, after, the wide-body era began, essentially, is, going to be from LA to Kuala Lumpur, and it's going to be with a 747. So, let me just check how popular Kuala Lumpur is. Yeah, that's sort of 747-ish. 8,793 miles. That will have to be with a 200, because the 100 doesn't have that range, I do not think, so. What's the 100s? That's 6,000 miles. What's the 200s? 7,000 miles. That might not make it, actually. That might not. So, yeah, let's just get that. And put some coating on it and everything, and if it doesn't work, then we'll just use it anyway, like on another route, probably going somewhere else in Asia, because I think the Asian routes are going to be the next part of our expansion, because from New York in the 1960s I was going from hang on, I need to put those on. In the 1960s, I was going from New York into Europe. And that's New York State, essentially the gateway to Europe from the US, for my airline. And I want Los Angeles to be the gateway to the Asian countries. So, the Asian countries. To Asia! There we go. So we can use that DC-10-10 to set up another route. I don't know where it would be. There's not actually that many, that many places left there to go, because I've pretty much covered all the popular places with the DC-10. What's that? Ooh, Bahamas is beginning to gain attention as a travel destination. In the 1990s, when like, the A321, A320 comes out and stuff like that, that section is going to be completely covered. I'm telling you, I'm not doing it now, simply because the places like Georgetown and that, look at that, they're either not open, or they have, really, really low like business and tour. Like there, and Dominico, and they all have really low business and tour, I'm just gonna leave it for now. There might be a couple of places, but I just want to make sure that, I'm covering, and that place, and it's, actually gonna be bringing in, some form of profit, it's not going to be a very low, capacity. That's our highest profit, I do believe, 233 million. I did say that these planes would really push us up into profit. What was our top profit with the DC-8s? I can't actually remember. I think we just about broke 100 million or something like that. Because I was saying about that. We broke, it was about 132 million or something like that. So we've added an extra 100 million on top of our profit, pretty much. With these DC-10 Simple 7. So they're pretty good. So. Right, how much range does that have? I doubt it's 8,700 miles or whatever it was. Let's just have a look. Da -da -da -da. Oh, 9,000 miles! Whoa! Didn't realise it would do that much. So let's start up that route then, from Los Angeles. So Ryan Pam or whoever it was. I can't remember. You know who you are, and I'm putting in the route for you. So since even though it's so it's so far, and I'd normally put in about like 4 or 3 slots. Probably gonna put in 5 because it's going. Because of the coating, it makes it go like 10% faster or something like that. That means there'll be more slots in Kuala Lumpur. So, More schedules a week, sorry. Yeah, that I'll need to put in Kuala Lumpur. So, yeah, that was right. More schedules a week, meaning I need to put more slots in Kuala Lumpur. There we go. I'm sorry, I can hear a really high-pitched beep. And that stopped. It just like, beep, for about 10 seconds. I was like, okay. So yeah, as you can see, it's only 4. Yeah, sometimes I don't judge it correctly, but it's alright. It doesn't matter, screamingly. Alright, let me just put up first class. Oh, I can get it at 6,900. Lovely, so... Oh yeah, oh, since it's three meals, yeah, you definitely know that we're going to need all of these cabin service. Yes, my voice just broke in. Ooh! Oh, good grief. So yeah, if I just put all those in. Then I want noodle soup. Then I want some teriyaki salmon. And then I want salmon steak. Beef stew. And salmon steak. There we go. sometimes I'm going to do it in noodle soup, sometimes I have to do it with other things, but yeah, since that route is absolutely really long, very, very lengthy, very, very far to see. You know what I mean? I would have to, put that salmon steak in, so yeah, if I just get rid of that slot, that's your route in, whoever suggested it. Sorry, I forgot your name, you know you are, as I said, so yeah, that's your euro put in, so... Now I want to start thinking about where I'm going to go, because I already go to Tokyo. Seoul I want to go to, that's definitely 747. Shanghai, that's a lot lower than I thought it would be. I think it just, because it absolutely shoots up in the late 1990s. You should see it. I mean, I think it was early 2000s. It was 500 at one point I saw. Tour was 500, business was 400. It's absolutely massive places, getting close to sort of London size, so... Alright, Hong Kong, that can be a DC-10, if that could go there. I don't know if it would be able to. That's Shenzhen. Where's Hong Kong? I want to go to Hong Kong. Right, there we go. Right, Hong Kong, it can be a 747, so 1 747, 2 747s, 3 747s, Beijing... 747. You know what? Let's just get them. We've got a bunch of money, which we'll probably just use up absolutely instantly. What about Taipei? Oh no, that can be like a DC-10, I should think. We were going to go to Sydney, weren't we? That's probably DC-10. So yeah, what do we have? We have, Seoul, Shanghai, Beijing, and Hong Kong. So yeah, we've got those are four 747 routes. So yeah, let's go buy them then. As I did say, the long haul routes now, I'm going to be using the 200, simply because there's a lot more range. If I have high capacity routes which don't have much range, then I'll use the 100. And I should think eventually I'll probably replace it, I don't know what I'd replace it with. Because if it's really high capacity, that's a good point. Because if there's a route, because something like Los Angeles to New York, or like Los Angeles to Chicago or something like that, it's an absolute cash cow of a route, and oh my gosh, that's a lot of money. I can just about get three, so yeah, we just won't have one of them. Okay then, 5 million, look at that, just that little 5 million left in our bank. I don't know, because I guess I could choose like the 747-400, who knows. Oh, 242 million. What is going on? We have a massive profit increase. We haven't set a single route up. Probably because of that, where did we go? I can't remember where we got. Oh, 737-100 is going out of production. Because we replaced that, 747, didn't we? Due to lack of customer satisfaction. Lack of counters, customer satisfaction, you know what it is. You can read, I should think, unless it's so low quality, you can't. If you play Air Tycoon 4, you know what that says pretty much. Let me just get that down there like that. And I also need to make it on the offices as well. And the counters seem to be, they seem to have a lot more, they seem to be fill up a lot quicker and be a lot more used than the offices. If you actually see, if I go into somewhere not like New York, you can actually see, if you look at that, I've got 54 counters, no, 37. Offices, and they're about the same level, so yeah, I could do with just a few more of each of them. and by the things of it. I'd like to try and keep it under 50% if you didn't know. The game, it only starts, like, the bar only starts going yellow after, like, 75% or something like that. But I just like to, yeah, keep it out of the zone. And at 50% seems, like, yeah, I, a pretty, good number. And there was a yellow strip that just came across the screen then. If you haven't watched this series before, and, yeah, you see all sorts of graphical glitches and everything like that. Yeah, that's just the game. Like, it's not my tablet, because every other thing runs completely fine. It runs completely fine. On this device, it's something about the game. I don't know what it is, Alright, I should just get that in Los Angeles, and then we can just fast forward some more turns. And we can go and get the 747. So, alright, we did fast forward that time before, so yeah, just after this turn we should get it. 247! Are we gonna break 250 million this episode? If it's going up at that rate, and I've only put in one blooming route, well, I haven't even put in a route, it was just a, yeah. God, Atlanta's at it now. Yeah, it wasn't even a route, it was, literally just phasing a DC-10 with a 747. I don't know, and something, what the what? Okay. Something happened there, I don't know what that was. Good grief above, look at this, it's really, really popular. That's why, yeah, I don't know, I was going to say I was going to try and talk about some plans that hopefully I have for the future, but yeah, I guess we can talk about them when we get to that point. So that'll be more sort of like mid-80s, so we need to start thinking about that seriously. Where was the biggest place? I think it was, look at Shanghai now. It's, hang on, what's the business on here? It doesn't matter. We'll go to Seoul. This is actually one of the hubs which I have in Norwich Airways. And I swear that IL-18, if I just get rid of that, the IL-18, I swear when I loaded it up, it just, like, popped into existence and went, and then slowed down a bit. I have no idea. So, yeah, I'll probably need 5 slots, seems about right. I don't know. how far is it? It'll be 5 slots. I usually fizz between about 5,400 miles and about 6,000 miles in a year. It's usually, 5 slots. It could be 4 slots or 4, I know, but it could be at the top end of the scale. But 5 slots, who knows? Who knows what it is, we'll use our second sub-4-7-200 now. And yeah, in the game, they didn't actually change anything apart from the windows at the top, I think. But they actually have different engine types, I do believe. It's 6? Wow. Didn't think it would be 6, but whatever. Let's just put that slot in there then. We can do that. Very, very busy airport. What level is it? Level 5. I don't usually pay attention to the level of the airport. Yeah, I only really do it when I've actually bought it. And I'm looking to upgrade it. So, speaking of which, if we start making a lot more money, we could essentially buy Los Angeles and then New York at some point. I guess it would have to be Los Angeles first, because that's actually where we're based at. And then it can be New York, and then I guess we could do some sort of, buy my next hub if I wanted to. I think what I should do, because I know I think it's around the late 1970s, you have like the passenger crisis. I think it's around then, I don't know, it could literally strike at any point, and there was one around then, but I think in sort of like the 1980s we could do it in like the late 1970s, I don't know, but yeah, I think that Los Angeles, if we start setting up a bunch of long haul routes now, we can get money from these long haul routes, and then we can start thinking about short haul, because I mean, I'm not against short haul. As I said, in the How to Set Up Effective Airline video, it's just best to actually, set up long-haul routes first, and then you've got stable money coming in, and then you can start thinking about short-haul ones, because, long-haul ones, especially against things like the 737 and then the 747, the 747 makes more than twice the amount that the 737 does. So, that would be that then. Let's go to Shanghai then, because that's also at 400. There's just so many in China. China has got to have the most popular cities of any blooming country. Because the amount that I get there is absolutely insane. Like, a Norwich Airways, I'm going to almost every blooming city. I mean, now there's probably a bunch of them, and I just knocked my camera. Yeah. And I've got Shanghai. Hangzhou's probably pretty high. Yeah, that's sort of high. Hangzhou. Nanjing, Qingdao, or whatever that's called. Yeah. Look at these places. I'll just show you around a bit. Look at this. That one's not even open. Look. Look at this. There's just so many high places there. And my business and tour. Yeah, they're very, very popular. So, yeah. I mean, some of them didn't look that popular. But believe me, with Norwich Airways, yeah, they do get a very, very popular eventually. Los Angeles has just hit 400 business by the seems of it. So yeah, I do believe that's the only one in this yeah on this map that has that. I think London might have that actually. I'll have to check in a minute. I was bang on 5. So yeah, if I just put that like that. Oh no, I was trying to get 1100, but I can't. And if I just put that up to 1120, and I put this up to I don't know. Can I get it up to 2800? Yes, I can. Not 2801. And with this one, I'll try and not actually break the blooming thing. Can I get 5,600? Yes, I can. Good, right! Oh, there's three of these, then we'll definitely need... Definite. Yeah, definite. We definite need every coin. I don't know what I'm saying. So, yeah. If I just get all of these, like that, so then I want, yeah. Same thing that I did with, what was it? Was it, it was Seoul, wasn't it? I don't know. Oh, Kuala Lumpur! Well done, me. So, yeah. Oh, no. I want that one, and I guess I could actually put could I put this in? Apparently that would do it, but I was looking for noodle soup. Yeah, I can. There's a tip, just put noodle soup at the end. So, yeah. And that's what that one done. Yeah, then we're gonna start doing some more routes. What I'll do is I think I'll set up these routes and yeah, then I'll I'll start buying some like in timeouts. I'll buy some and set them up in timeouts. Cause yeah, if we get these long haul ones going, yeah, then we can I think the next one for me will be 737 because yeah, we have sort of expanded over America a bit, but yeah, we haven't done it completely. And yeah, new airports are opening all the time. So yeah, there's a lot more opportunities for more routes and more money coming in. So yeah, let's just set up. Was this the last one? Oh yeah, because we could only get 3, wasn't it? Thought it was, and I can hear a blooming fighter jet going on outside. Press next, for God's sake. Oh, that's 6 again. Good grief. Good grief above. I can hear. I think it's a jet and a helicopter going past. I don't know, so yeah. Actually, when while I was on the offline as well, because I just saw the Elton 11 taxiing there. Is it the Elton 11 500 there? No, yeah, I should. I don't know, for some reason, I haven't actually really looked at the Elton 11 that much. Yeah, after I saw the first variant, I was like, no, I'm not getting that because it doesn't have, first class. But I did have the 500 as, because, yeah. I think the whole series probably doesn't have it then. So yeah, I was surprised to find that the 757 had it when I first got it. Yeah, I didn't think it was, because I thought it was just like a medium-haul aircraft. Well, it sort of is, but it can do sort of some long-haul stuff, so yeah. Good grief, how low does this blooming first class one its prices? There you go. Oh, good grief, so yeah. This episode will probably be a long one, yeah, like a few episodes ago it was, because yeah. That one was half an hour, so yeah. A few episodes ago, so yeah, let me just put in all of these, all of these, all of these, all of these. And yeah, well, I need some of the, food in here. Sam mistake, can I get a noodle soup in there? I think I can. Yes, I can. I'm getting very Asian dishes with this, aren't I? Because yeah, I use Asian dishes because yeah, they seem to have a high popularity. And yeah, we're actually going to Asian countries, so it sort of makes sense. So yeah, we've got 400 million now, and I'm moving really slowly. So yeah, should we just go into time-lapse now? Yeah, I think we should. Should we just do some more DC-10s and things like that? Or should we do some more 747s? Because if I just have a look at Singapore. What's Singapore? Oh, yeah, that's pretty high. I just want to see how far away it is, actually. Well, if I go, actually, no. Because with the Kuala Lumpur, I managed to get there with a super coating, so yeah. I guess I could just do that. Is there any other places in Japan I could go to? Osaka, that could be a DC-10. Yeah. Should we go to Pyongyang? I know, well, right, we were going to go to Hong Kong, weren't we? Yeah, Hong Kong, not Taipei, so Hong Kong, Manila maybe? No. Hong Kong, we could go to Bangkok, that's DC-10. So Hong Kong and Singapore, so those are the ones we're definitely going to go to. Jakarta? I don't know, I think I moved my camera. Yeah, I did. Sorry if I do that and I don't notice for a while. Oh god, no. And Sydney we were thinking about, weren't we? Yeah, that's sort of nearly 747, but not quite, so. Brisbane is just a very, very low. So yeah, what was that? So that's 2 747s, and I'll see if I could get anything more. And I'll probably have to fast forward a couple of turns to do this, so yeah. Let's go then! Quite a while, but I've put those routes in, so yeah, the ones I did, if I go under here, it'll be easy to see which ones I put in. Yeah, I went to, no, wrong ones. This one I went to, and just Hong Kong and Singapore in that time lapse. And with the 747 and with the 737 200, if I just get it up, there we go. Where else do I go to? I also renovated them as well, because I was thinking, well, I didn't really know whether I actually did it before. I probably did. Okay, there's some beeping outside again. as you can see, it was because of the percentages. Satisfaction is from Los Angeles to Springfield, Shreveport, and from New York to Charleston. So, that is pretty much the end of this episode, I think, because otherwise I'll be going on for a million years. So, next episode, I guess that we can, start setting up a lot more routes, with, and things like the 737 and that. As I said, I want Los Angeles to be the gateway to Asia, so I'll be getting a lot more 747s and things like that. So I can do that. I'll probably be getting some more DC-10s as well, because, not all of them are 747 capacity, and I can, increase their ranges with, the super engine and fuselage coating, so, And that was it. That's the end of this episode here, so thank you very much for watching, and thank you for taking my EBD. If you choose my channel, I click on this video, and hope you got to just like, if you did, It's been, a bit of a hectic episode though, this one, I've been, that 747, and we've been, setting more routes up with the 747, and 737, and doing the time maps, and all sorts. I think, that's a pretty good progress for today, so again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video, if you suggest that one as well. Bye! I just, 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 I just,